Hi and welcome to Jyotishi.com. So today we are going to be talking about the Mrigashira Nakshatra, which lies in Taurus and the Gemini sign of the natural zodiac. So let's see what the Mrigashira Nakshatra means to us, and when Moon is in Mrigashira or any planet is in Mrigashira, what are the personality traits, what are the best careers for us. So let's look at this and talk to Anand about this on a detailed perspective. So today let's continue with the nakshatra series and talk about a new nakshatra today, which is the Mrigashira nakshatra. Right. So it is represented by the head of a deer.
Yes.
So what is it that one can learn about Mrigashira nakshatra?
Yeah. So Mrigashira nakshatra comes in the Taurus and Gemini sign. So primarily in the Gemini kind of a sign, and it represents the Shira, the head of the Mriga, the animal. So that is why it's called Mrigashira. There is a story behind it. Prajapati, you know, created children and then wanted to sort of got attracted with his own children, and then Devi Saraswati took the form of deer, and then she ran and then was attacked, and then that's how the story of the Mrigashira comes here. So the primarily Mrigashira natives, it is to do with the, something to do with the face, something to do with the hands. So primarily the area of the face and the hands are very, very critical from a Mrigashira point of view. So for example, we'll try and explain certain characteristics using celebrity examples. So for example, the eyebrows in the case of Mrigashira Nakshatra are very, very prominent. So for example, if you take the celebrities like P. Sushila, so if you see her photo, you will clearly figure out that she's a Mrigashira Nakshatra. The eyebrows are very, very, very thick. So for example, Jim Carrey, the eyebrows are very, very, very prominent from
defined,
that,
right?
Very defined and very prominent. So for example, Jennifer Lawrence, Brooke Shields, so you know, you see the photo in entire Hollywood, you know, most of them will have a thin liner eyebrows. So these people, what we have mentioned, is very clearly defined eyebrows. And the entire area of the face, so for example, Jim Carrey, the entire career was defined by facial expressions, definitive kind of facial expressions. So that is very, very, that theme very clearly comes out from a Mrigashira.
And also to pull off a movie like Mask.
Yes. Right. So that is also to completely do with the face.
Right.
So something to do with eyebrow, the face, the eyes. Very gentle and very soft eyes. And the facial expressions are pretty strong from that perspective.
Okay.
From a Mrigashira
perspective.
Yes.
Got it. So now that's more about the face, right?
Yes.
Like the deer is also agile in the body. So
yes.
What is the body type like?
Yes. So any key planet in Mrigashira Nakshatra for any person, especially Moon or Venus, we can easily figure out that the person is born in Mrigashira Nakshatra. So for example, anybody with a long neck and will have a sort of an animal, deer or an antelope kind of a structure. I don't know if you have sort of figured out, if you notice people with these kind of structures, you will notice that they are sort of exactly looking like a deer kind of a thing. So Venus or a Moon from that perspective is a very strong kind of thing. And like a deer, these people always move in a herd. So they move in a herd, they move around only with known people and they move to known places. So for example, you want to sort of go out, so they will have one or two movie theaters to move out, and they will probably not explore multiple things. They will probably explore only one or two movie theaters. They will go only with their known circle and then go and come out. So exactly like a deer kind of a thing, and an agile sort of a body. So they're always sort of sniffing. So the ability to smell things is pretty strong. So from that perspective, you know, we can look at careers like, you know, perfume industry. We can look at careers like coffee industry. We can look at the psychic ability of that person to understand the other person and figure out the meanings is pretty strong. So the person, so psychologist, psychic healer, anything to do with counseling, anything to do with coaching, anything to do with training, all those are fantastic things for a Mrigashira Nakshatra. Because their ability to sniff out things are pretty strong, whether it is material or something related to the subconscious level as well. Yes.
Right. This is also additionally like sense of danger, right?
Yes.
So ability to sense danger.
Yes.
So that is something that comes easily to
deer.
So another thing with deers is also they are very caring, right? Like for example, like I saw a photo a few days ago where the mother had was being attacked by a couple of leopards.
Yes.
Because it had given itself up so that the children could go away.
Yes.
So what is it? You know, this ability of the person to give themselves up in that particular situation, or maybe commit to that, or take care of that situation. So does that also play out in
Mrigashira? So Mrigashira is ruled by the moon, Soma. So Soma is sort of it is called a nectar, and then it is in this particular area between the Sahasrara chakra and the throat chakra. So Soma sort of circulates in this particular area, and Soma moon is also related to Chandra, is also related to mother. So their nature inherently is very mridul, soft. So inherently they are sort of very mother like kind of people, and their connect with the mother is fantastic. Mrigashira Nakshatra and their mother, is the ability to connect is fantastic. And since moon is in the fourth house, Mrigashira is in the third house, that is the 12th house from the fourth house, most probably the Mrigashira native will be in foreign lands or very far away from their mother, though the connect is very strong. So most of the Mrigashiras, if you figure out any relative, known friends and all that, they will be mostly abroad, and then sort of mother will be
in
India or some other country, and then the distance sort of separates.
So another question, last week we spoke about the complete opposite, which was Jyeshta, right, where the moon is debilitated.
Yes.
Here one part is the moon can be exalted if it is in Taurus.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So like in terms of the mind, since you spoke about the moon, do they have a very strong mind?
Yes. So Mrigashira are sort of, there are two flavors, one is a Taurus flavor, one is a Gemini flavor.
Right.
So Taurus flavor is more of material.
Okay.
It's more of, so they will be inclined towards the second house activity.
Because it is the natural.
Yes. So more of, they will be craving for food, and they will like to buy articles, and they will like to buy fashion items and those kind of things. And the Mithuna Mrigashira types are primarily to do with, you know, writing, lectures, communication, sales and marketing, electronics and communication.
Right.
So all those are fantastic, mass communication, all those are fantastic. So for example, writing, we can talk about Salman Rushdie. We can also talk about Dr. B.V. Raman. B.V. Raman, though he's a great researcher and astrologer, he has his publications in the field of astrology is tremendous from that perspective. Yes.
Right. And also, Rudyard Kipling. Very hardworking because of the third house.
We cannot say exactly hardworking, but we can say that they are sort of soft and meticulous from the
third house perspective.
Got it. So that kind of a sense clearly comes out.
Okay, got it. And since they have a strong moon, what is the impact on relationship? Like generally, people who are, you know, have very stable mind are good people to be around with. Right?
Yes.
They're more happy.
Yes.
So I'm assuming that they have very cordial relationships, caring relationships with everyone.
Yes. In terms of relationships, their thing is reasonably strong. There is also a concept of moon. The moon's flavor coming out. Moon out of 27 wives likes Rohini very much, and moon also has a story wherein. So one flavor that comes out is this Mrigashira Nakshatra will be attached to one person. That is one flavor, only one person, kind of a person, and then because Rohini. And the second flavor that probably comes out is moon. You know, had a, there's a story between moon, Tara, and Jupiter. So Jupiter moon took away Tara's thing and then didn't want to give away, and that it was a fight between Asuras and Devas and all that. So from that concept, what comes out is that there is a probability that the Mrigashira Nakshatra people the position of children is not very strong. From so moon doesn't like Mercury. So from that thing, they are enemies from a natural perspective because of this moon Jupiter Tara story. And then so the position of children is not very strong. So you would probably find people who have not having children, or even if there are children, you know, their attitude towards their parents may not be very you know, sort of congenial kind of a thing.
Okay.
So this flavor is also pretty strong.
And does this happen with Moon in Taurus, Moon in Gemini specifically? Or?
Moon in Gemini specifically.
Okay, yes. But Moon in Taurus is okay.
Yes, but Moon in Taurus also has some sort of a flavor from this perspective.
Okay, got it. So any Moon is strong here.
Yes.
What can they? Is there any mantra or?
No, Moon is strong only in Taurus, not in Gemini.
Right. Okay.
So only, and Taurus is just a pada. So it is not, we cannot exactly say that Moon is strong.
Okay.
It is just the flavor of the Mrigashira
nakshatra.
And it also talks about your third house of communication, singing. So for example, B. Sushila, world record, Guinness record, 50,000 songs. So that kind of a thing. And third house of writing, Rudyard Kipling and those kind of, third house of hands. So you would find sort of Mithun Chakravarti kind of a flavor here. So most of his dances are only the head and the hands.
Right.
You know, so that kind of flavor very clearly comes out in this nakshatra.
Got it. This is like how in Hasta we discussed that the hand was very
yes.
the Titanic.
So that is primarily to do with palm. Here the entire hands
and
the neck. So
got
the
it.
Break dance
the
kind
face.
Of a, yes.
Got it.
Yes.
So that is something that is very prominent.
Very prominent in this.
Okay.
So that Mithun Chakravarti flavor in Mrigashira is also. So all these people, celebrities that we have told, if you can just go and watch, look at their eyebrows, you will sort of very clearly figure out anybody with thick eyebrows, you can be reasonably sure one of the key planets is Mrigashira nakshatra.
Okay.
And because of their smell instinct, their ability to smell the deer, you know, sort of smell and ability to understand things and all that. There is another flavor that comes out. So these guys are, since they are mridul and soft and those kind of things. So for example, any private space, they will sort of put perfume, you know, put flowers, decoration.
Take care of it.
Yes. So many other nakshatras are, when there are intimate sort of scenarios, they will decorate the room, you know, put perfume and flowers and all. So all that gives them a lot of flavor from a Mrigashira.
Okay.
A point of view.
Okay. Also, I don't know if this is the Old Spice musk.
Yes, musk.
Musk comes.
Yes, because
from
animal thing.
Yes.
You know, so musk flavor is very,
and
very
musk
strong.
And musk is one of the
yes.
deers.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. So musk, they will be very, very attached to a musk sort of a flavor.
Right.
It's not a feminine perfume.
Right.
It is a not a flower or a feminine,
yes.
but a musk related.
Right.
So that is, that flavor is very, very strong for a Mrigashira nakshatra kind of thing.
So
anything to do with kajal, anything to do with mask.
Taking care of themselves.
Yes, and taking care of themselves and all that, it's, that theme is pretty strong.
Okay.
Yes.
So like Anand mentioned, the most suitable career options for someone with, let's say, Moon in Mrigashira is something to do with bioresearch, something to do with plants. Something to do with in the space of perfumes, smelling things, right? Like coffee, like where the deer can smell things out, right? Something that where you are also nurturing and caring. So these are some career options that you can look at. And also from a relationship perspective, like Anand mentioned, they, you know, they try to like, it's also very nice to, you know, to be with them in because of the position of the moon in Taurus as such. And also if you look at it, there are certain qualities that Anand mentioned, right? Like for example, like the body type, or they like to be in like certain, what do you say? I wouldn't say it more comfortable environment is what they are more comfortable in actually, like something that is the, in their space, right? Or where they can, and also these people are very alert. If you would have seen a deer, deers are very alert. So these people are very alert. So if you have Moon in Mrigashira and would like to know more about how this is playing out in your life, do register with us on jyotishi.com. Thank you.